It's like when I say I live the thug life, baby, I'm hopeless. One person might hear that and just like the way it sounds, you know what I'm saying? But I'm doing it for the kid that really lives a thug life and feels like it's hopeless. So when I say hopeless, and when I say it like that, it's like I reach him. You understand? And even if when I reach him, it makes it look glorious to the guy that doesn't live that life. I can't help it. It's a fad, you know. He'll drop the thug life soon enough. But for the person that I was trying to reach, he'll pick it up and I'll be able to talk to him again.
Hey guys, I used to be one of the people Tupac mentioned at the beginning of the video who thought it was honestly cool to shout out thug life, throw up gang signs, and not really think about what it meant. Tupac hit the nail on the head, honestly, when he popularized the term in referring to society as a whole. Nearly everything bad about society can be retraced back to what people were exposed to in their earlier years. If a young boy grows up seeing his abusive alcoholic father beat his mother and sisters on a regular basis, odds are the boy will grow up and think this behavior is normal and repeat the cycle with his own wife and kids. If a young girl grows up seeing rules be repeatedly broken and being told the end justifies the means, she could end up being a leader of a huge company that believes corruption is normal, passes this on to her subordinates, and this mentality spreads like wildfire through the organization and to the point that the entire country believes corruption is as normal as breathing air, which sadly is the case with a lot of developing countries around the world. All the successful good leaders that you know of today became who they are as a result of their childhoods. And the same can be said for the dictators of today, became who they are as a result of their childhoods. Their beliefs, their character, their morals were all formed in these early stages. If you want to understand someone, observe the household, or lack thereof, that they grew up in, and I'm sure you will find most of the answers to your questions. This is why it is so important as people that we do our part in our own households. Everyone on this planet has a father and a mother, but unfortunately, not everyone has a parent. There's a big difference. Having sex and creating a child is the easy part. Might take on average 20 minutes to do so, or less if you get excited, but being a dad or mom is a lifelong commitment. It is in this commitment that parents need to shape their children into people they themselves can be proud of. The foundation of whether a child goes down the route of thug life begins here. A good representation of this is in the movie The Hate U Give by Angie Thomas, based on the book of the same name. The story revolves around a young black girl named Star, who is constantly switching between two worlds, the poor, mostly black neighborhood where she lives, and the wealthy, mostly white prep school she attends. The balance between these two worlds is soon shattered as Star witnesses the fatal shooting of her childhood best friend at the hands of a white police officer. I can't even begin to recommend this movie to you enough without actually spoiling it, which I don't want to do. I accidentally stumbled upon it whilst browsing through YouTube and I saw an intriguing thumbnail in my suggested videos. I was so impacted by the movie that by the end of it, I immediately went on my laptop, searched for the ebook, got it, and finished it in one day. One day. The two key areas to nail any story are the beginning and the end, as these are the moments that the audience remembers long after leaving the story. And this movie really hits it out of the park. The character development is amazing. The representation of both worlds is something most people will be able to relate to. The pacing is as close to perfect as you can get in movies. There's something here for all ages, races, and genders. It currently holds a Rotten Tomatoes score of 97%, making it certified fresh. And anyone that knows Rotten Tomatoes knows this is really hard to do these days, as most critics love, and I mean love, giving negative scores for website clicks and controversy, which sells better than positivity. The film did not receive much coverage outside of the United States, as literally when I went to my local cinema and asked, yo, do you guys have the movie in stock? They looked at me as if I'd lost my mind. And until I actually showed them the Wikipedia page for the movie and saying this movie came out like 2 weeks ago, how come it's not in cinemas? They actually look and say, oh, they had no idea this movie existed. And that's a damn shame, because if I really think these are the kind of thought-provoking movies society should be watching more of. And I'm sure most of you literally in this video, this is the first time you've probably heard of this movie/book. But to summarize, we don't have a control over many things in this world. But the two things we do have control over are what we say and what we do. Children learn best not from what they're told, but from what they see. Be the example of what makes a person good, and hopefully that prevents them from going down the route of thug life. Thanks for watching the video, guys. I'll see you in the next one.